I am Vijay Kumar S. Biradar, working as Assistant Professor in Electrical Engineering Department and HOD of General Science and Engineering at N.B. Nawale Sinhagad College of Engineering, Solapur, with 19 years of experience. Today we are going to discuss the subject Control System 2 for Electrical Engineering, with the topic that today we discuss is about the pole placement using transformation matrix. In our previous lecture, we seen the pole placement technique which is used for controller design and to determine the state feedback gain matrix K. There are three approaches that can be used to determine the state feedback gain matrix K to place the poles at desired locations. The first method is the transformation matrix T. The second method is the direct substitution method. And third is Ackermann's formula for determination of state feedback gain matrix K. All these methods are going to derive or obtain the same results. There are certain assumptions which need to assume before proceeding towards the methods. The first assumption is that the system is completely state controllable. This assumption is basically the necessary and sufficient condition for system to design the controller. The state variables are measurable and are available for feedback, and the third assumption is that the control input is unconstrained. We'll consider the system. Suppose that the system is defined by the state equation x dot is equal to ax plus bu with control signal given by u is equal to minus kx. Then there are steps which we should follow to design or to obtain the pole placement using this transformation matrix. The first step is to check the controllability of the given system. With the help of the Kalman test, we can obtain the controllability matrix. Cm is equal to b, ab, a square b, up to a raised to n minus 1 b. This particular condition is for the system with order equal to n. If the rank of this controllability matrix is n, then the system is said to be completely state controllable. So if the system is completely state controllable, then and then only it is possible to obtain the state feedback gain matrix. Otherwise, it is not possible to design a controller or to obtain the state feedback gain matrix K. Next step, from the characteristic polynomial which is to be obtained from the matrix A, with the help of determinant of Si minus A, which is equal to S raised to n plus A1 S raised to n minus 1 and so on plus An minus 1 into S plus An, will determine the values of A1 to An. Then we'll determine the transformation matrix T that transform the system state equation into controllable canonical form. If the system is not given in controllable canonical form, we need to transform that representation into controllable canonical form. And if the system is already given in controllable canonical form, then this transformation matrix T is equal to an identity matrix. So the transformation matrix is given by T is equal to Cm into W, where Cm is the controllability matrix, which is the same as we used it in the first step. And this W is obtained from that characteristic polynomial of the system with the coefficients in the first row as an minus 1, an minus 2 up to a1, and the last element is 1. In second element or in second row, what we need to do is we need to shift this towards the left side one by one to the preceding rows, and the last elements are going to be represented as zeros. So we'll obtain the W as an minus 1, an minus 2 up to a1 and 1. The second row becomes an minus 2, an minus 3. The second last element is 1 and the last element will be 0. In a similar way, we'll proceed and the last row becomes 1, 0, 0. All the remaining elements will be 0. Therefore, we'll obtain the A bar matrix, that is transformation matrix, B bar, C bar and D bar also in some cases. Therefore, A bar is equal to T inverse AT, B bar is equal to T inverse B, C bar is equal to CT. With this, we will obtain the matrix A bar basically as T inverse AT, which can be seen that the T inverse AT matrix, that is A bar matrix, is having only the last row as the coefficients of the A minus AN minus AN minus 1 and so on. Next, we will determine or will obtain the desired characteristic equation from the desired eigenvalues. The desired eigenvalues are mentioned in the example itself, or it is known to us. If the desired eigenvalues are mu 1, mu 2 and so on up to mu n, then we can generate the characteristic equation as S minus mu 1, S minus mu 2 into S minus mu n, which is equal to S raised to n plus alpha 1 S raised to n minus 1 plus alpha 2 S raised to n minus 2 up to the last element will be alpha n. Then from this characteristic equation, we'll determine the values of alpha 1, alpha 2 up to alpha n. Then the required state feedback gain matrix K can be determined from the equation K is equal to alpha n minus an. Then second element is alpha n minus 1 minus an minus 1 up to alpha 2 minus a2 and alpha 1 minus a1 into T inverse. So this is the equation with which we can determine the state feedback gain matrix K. Let us have an example for the better understanding of this concept of transformation matrix to calculate the state feedback gain matrix. So the system, consider the regulator system shown in the following figure. The plant is given by X dot is equal to AX plus BU, where A is a constant matrix and B is also a constant matrix. The system uses the state feedback control U is equal to minus KX. The desired eigenvalues are mu 1, mu 2 and mu 3, which are given. Determine the state feedback gain matrix K. So we need to first check the controllability of the matrix. Since the controllability matrix is given as the existing system is of third order, so we'll take only three elements in the controllability matrix. The first element is B, second is AB and third one is A square B. So we have calculated that controllability matrix and we'll check the rank of this matrix. The rank of the given controllability matrix is 3, therefore the system is completely state controllable and arbitrary pole placement is possible. The second step, transformation to controllable canonical form. The given system is already in controllable canonical form, therefore the transformation matrix T is equal to I, that is the identity matrix. The next, we'll calculate the characteristic equation. So determinant of SI minus A is equal to, it is calculated as S cube plus 6S square plus 5S plus 1, which is equal to 0. From this, we can obtain the values of A1 is equal to 6, A2 is equal to 5 and A3 is equal to 1. The desired characteristic polynomial can be computed using the desired eigenvalues, which are given as mu 1, mu 2, mu 3. Mu 1 is equal to minus 2 plus j4, mu 2 is equal to minus 2 minus j4, mu 3 is equal to minus 1. From this, we'll obtain the polynomial as S cube plus 14S square plus 60S plus 200, which is compared with the equation S cube plus alpha 1S square plus alpha 2S plus alpha 3. Hence, alpha 1 is equal to 14, alpha 2 is equal to 60 and alpha 3 is equal to 200. Therefore, we have the values of A1, A2, A3, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. So, we can obtain the value of K with the equation as alpha 3 minus A3, alpha 2 minus A2 and alpha 1 minus A1. So, we will get the values of K as 199, 55 and 8. Therefore, K1, K2, K3 we designed as the system is of third order. So, we have the values of K1, K2, K3. So, this is the representation of the existing system where in feedback we have minus 6, minus 5, minus 5 as so actually it is minus 1. So, coefficients of the X3, X2 and X1. And with the help of this state feedback gain matrix, the existing system is modified like this. And this is the block diagram for the system after placing the state feedback gain matrix K with the control U is equal to minus KX. Thank you.